we continue with oscillations. In the last lecture, we learned that what an oscillation is, and we learned that oscillations of a system can take place only about a position of stable equilibrium. We also learned the characteristics of a simple harmonic motion, that is, the acceleration of the system is proportional to the displacement and is in direction opposite to the displacement. And now we shall apply these concepts to do examples, and then we shall go on to see how two or more simple harmonic oscillations can be combined. So, let us start with a few problems. Here we have a block of mass m which is dipped in water. It is slightly in water. It is in equilibrium because its own weight is equal to the weight of the water that it has displaced. Now, suppose we dip it slightly more. We press it so that it dips by an amount y, a very small amount y, additional amount y, and then we leave it. As we leave it, we find the block starts oscillating. First of all, we want to establish that these oscillations are simple harmonic, and then we want to find out the time period of these oscillations. Because the displacement y, the volume of liquid displaced is yA, where A is the area of cross section, and the weight of this additional liquid displaced is AY times rho g. Rho is density and g is the acceleration due to gravity. And this weight is pushing the system upwards. This additional displacement of water is pushing the system upward. Remember that we initially pushed the system downwards, and there is a restoring force now which is pushing it upwards. And this is the force which is pushing it upwards, and the acceleration is simply divided by m. So, it is A rho g by m into y. And you can see I placed the minus sign. Minus because displacement was downwards, the restoring acceleration is upwards, and therefore, I can write it A equal to minus A rho g by m times y. And you can see it is equal to A of the same type, A equal to minus omega squared y. This implies that the oscillations are simple harmonic. They also imply that the frequency is given by omega squared equal to A rho g by m, and the time period therefore is 2 pi m by A rho g, where A is the area of cross section, rho is the density of the liquid, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and m is the mass of the block. Let me remind you that we had a block of mass m which we had pushed downwards slightly, and then it starts oscillating because there is restoring force upwards. Let us take another example, a U tube. A U tube has a liquid in it, you know, it must be at the same level when in equilibrium. Then, say in the right column, we apply some force or we just blow into it so that the liquid column goes down. If this liquid column goes down by amount y, this liquid column goes up by amount y, that is the difference between these two columns is 2y. So, we want to find out what the oscillations, whether the system oscillates and if these oscillations are simple harmonic. So, the liquid in the left column moves upwards by amount y, so that the difference in the lengths of the two columns is 2y. The extra pressure due to height difference 2y, you know, is 2y rho g times A, that is the force. The extra pressure is 2y rho g and multiplied by the area of cross section of the tube. This gives us the force which is pushing the liquid downwards. You know, the liquid was displaced upwards, and this force, this extra pressure due to this difference 2y, is pushing the liquid downwards. And what is being pushed? This whole liquid in this column of length L, whole of this liquid is being pushed. So, the restoric force, as I have said, is downwards, whereas the initial displacement was upwards. So, I can write A equal to minus 2 rho g A by m times y. You see, 2 rho g a y was the force. I divide by the mass of this liquid, which is m, and then I get acceleration equal to minus 2 rho g a by m times y. And this again is of the form minus omega squared y, a equal to minus omega squared y. Therefore, this gives me omega squared. Omega squared is 2 rho g a by m. So, from this I can get the time period, and the time period is 2 g by L. Why? Because m I have replaced by a rho times L. A is the area of cross section, L is the length. Therefore, a L is the volume multiplied by density is the mass of the liquid column of length L. So, I have replaced m by a rho L, and then I get time period which is equal to 2 pi under root of L by 2 g. So, the oscillations are simple harmonic, and the time period of these oscillations is 2 pi root of L by 2 g. Now, a simpler one. We are given certain functions. What are those functions? Acceleration is equal to k x. Acceleration is equal to minus k 0 x times plus k 1 x square. Acceleration is equal to minus k x plus b. Acceleration equal to k x plus b. And we have to recognize which one of them represents simple harmonic motion. You know, what is the criteria? That the acceleration must be minus times the displacement, and only this c satisfies this criterion. You know, here we have x square, which is not required. Therefore, it is not simple harmonic motion. This is plus k x, not simple harmonic motion. Plus k x plus b, not simple harmonic motion. Minus k into x plus b is the simple harmonic motion. Why? Do not worry about this constant b. Constant b is simply the change of scale on which x is measured. You see, the 0 has been shifted by amount b. So, x is 0 at minus b. So, do not worry about b. B is a constant, and the acceleration is equal to minus k times x, or may minus k times whatever displacement is measured from minus b. So, this is the one that represents the simple harmonic motion. The others do not. Again, out of the following functions representing motion of particle, which ones represent SHM? That means, the answer can be more than one. And the functions are y equal to sin omega t minus cos omega t, b y equal to sin cubed omega t, y equal to 5 cos minus 3 pi by 4 minus 3 omega t, and d is equal to y equal to 1 plus omega t plus omega square t. Again, remember that a sine function or a cosine function or a combination of two can only represent a simple harmonic motion. A combination of sine and cosine functions of the same frequency can represent a simple harmonic motion. And what are those two functions? You can see this is sine plus cos. So, this is a combination of sine and cos of the same frequency. This is just cos. So, these two can represent simple harmonic motions. These cannot. This is sine cubed, not the one that represents the simple harmonic motion. And here there is no sine function at all. So, we going by the fact that the simple harmonic motion has either a sine function or a cosine function or a combination of these two functions, we conclude that A and C are the correct answers. In fact, I will like you to do this as an exercise. Show that if you take y equal to 5 cos etcetera this function, then you show explicitly that A is equal to minus omega squared y. It is easy. You can do that. Let us take another example. A point performs simple harmonic oscillations of period t, and the equation of motion is given by x equal to a sin omega t plus pi by 6. After the elapse of what fraction of the time period, the velocity of the point will be equal to half of its maximum velocity. You know, this NEET, this indicates that this question has been asked in one of the competitive examinations held by CBSE. I have chosen some problems from those examinations. So, the solution, we are given x equal to this. So, v is equal to omega a cos omega t plus pi by 6, and the maximum velocity is when cos is 1, that is omega a, and half of this is omega a by 2. So, our equation becomes omega a by 2 equal to omega a cos omega t plus pi by 6. And from this, if we cancel omega a, we get half, and this is cosine function, and you know cosine is half when the function is pi by 3. So, we have pi by 3 equal to omega t plus pi by 6, and from this you can find t equal to t by 12. Another example, a mass of 2 kilogram is attached to a spring with spring constant of 18 newton per meter. It is then displaced to the point x equal to 2, that is, we have a spring and it is attached to a mass, and then we stretch it and take it to a point where x is equal to 2. How much time does it take for the block to travel to the point x equal to 1? We took it x equal to 2, and the question wants you to find out the time in which it will come back to x equal to 1. Again, the motion of the spring is simple harmonic, we know that. We know its frequency is k by m, where k is the spring constant. If we substitute these values, we will find omega equal to 3 hertz. And therefore, the equation of motion is x equal to 2 cos omega t, which is 2 cos 3 t, because omega is now 3. The equation of the motion is x equal to 2 cos omega t, which is 2 cos 3 t. When x is equal to 2 in this equation, then 3 t is equal to 0, because cos of 0 is 1. So, when x is equal to 1, the equation is 1 plus 2 cos 3 t, which gives us 3 t equal to pi by 3. And therefore, from 0 time to this time, is from this equation, time is pi by 9, which is equal to 0.35 seconds. So, you could also use the other function, x equal to 2 sin omega t plus theta. It won't matter. It will give you the same answer. Another example. Now, we have two horizontal spring systems, which are performing simple harmonic motion with equal amplitudes. However, the force constant of spring A is 4 times as large as the force constant of spring B. How do their maximum speeds compare? You see, remember that omega is k by m, and v is equal to a omega cos omega t plus theta, and the maximum velocity is a omega. Since the force constant of spring A is 4 times that of B, the frequency of omega A being proportional to root of k is 2 omega B. So, V maximum A is equal to twice V maximum B. The total energy, which is proportional to max squared of the spring A, will be 4 times that of spring B. Let us take another example. Here we have got two springs like this. They are attached to the same mass, and then they are attached to solid surfaces. So, two identical springs of spring constant K, both have spring constant K, are connected to a mass M as shown. Determine the time period of small amplitude oscillations. So, what happens? When we displace, say, mass this way or this way, one of the springs is stretched while the other is compressed. But the force in both cases is simply kx. We know from the spring equation, the force is equal to kx. So, the restoring force on each spring will be kx. The total restoring force will be 2kx. Kx for one, kx for the other, and the total restoring force would be 2kx. You see, if this is compressed, this will tend to push it this way. If this is stretched, this will tend to push it this way, and the total force is 2kx. The restoring force will produce an acceleration 2k by m times x, and comparing with this, we find omega is 2k by m, and t is equal to 2 pi m by 2k. Note that the spring constants have been added. In this case, they were equal, they have been added. We shall see later that they are actually added. So, k plus k is 2k. If we have k 1 and k 2, then we will have k 1 plus k 2. So, in general, when springs are arranged in this manner, they are called parallel springs, then k effective is k 1 plus k 2, and the frequency is k 1 plus k 2 by m, which is omega 1 squared plus omega 2 squared under root. In the next lecture, we will continue with oscillations, and we shall study what are known as damped oscillations, that is, oscillations in which the amplitude keeps on decreasing and slowly the system comes to rest, and forced oscillations, where the system is forced by a periodic force so that the amplitudes continue. The oscillations are maintained by a force. Those are called forced oscillations. So, we shall see what damped oscillations are and what forced oscillations are, and we shall see their characteristics.